the Dutch government published a consultation document with a proposal to counter tax avoidance through transfer pricing differences between the Netherlands and other countries. But what is the reason for this proposal? And what does it mean exactly? I'm happy to provide you with some background information on this topic, followed by an explanation of the content of the proposal. According to the Dutch Corporate Income Tax Act, transactions between related parties should occur in accordance with the arm's length principle. In case a transaction is not executed in accordance with this principle, a downwards or an upwards transfer pricing adjustment will take place. And this will take place through an informal capital contribution or a deemed dividend distribution at the level of the Dutch income taxpayer. In case the country of the related counterparty does not recognize such transfer pricing adjustment, international mismatches may occur, resulting in a deduction without a pickup. On this slide, you see two examples of mismatches resulting from transfer pricing corrections. In the first situation, a 0% interest loan is granted by A Limited to the Dutch BV. As a result of the arm's length principle, the Dutch BV will deduct interest against 5%. In this example, country A did not implement the arm's length principle. Hence, no correction on the profit will take place at the level of A Limited. In the second example, A Limited transfers IP to the Dutch BV. The IP has a book value of 2 million euros and a fair market value of 5 million euros. Based on Dutch tax law, a step-up will be provided to the BV for the fair market value. The BV can amortize the IP with taking into account the higher fair market value. Country A, however, does not levy an exit tax for the difference between the fair market value and the book value. I will now clarify the proposal and provide you with some examples. The legislative proposal states that the taxable profit of a Dutch taxpayer cannot be adjusted downwards as a result of a transaction with another company if the taxable profit of the other company is not adjusted upwards accordingly. As a result, the so-called informal capital structures are countered. In the first example of this slide, the Netherlands will disallow the deduction of interest as there is no upwards adjustment at the level of A Limited. The legislative proposal also provides for a rule regarding the onshoring of assets from a group company to the Netherlands. In case the transferring company does not have to adjust the sales price of these assets to a fair market value, the Netherlands will refuse to provide a step-up for the fair market value of the assets of the acquiring company. In the second example of this slide, the Netherlands will refuse the fair market value step-up of the BV. In order to benefit from the downwards adjustment, the Dutch corporate income taxpayer must demonstrate that there's a corresponding upwards adjustment and that this adjustment is included in the taxable base of the counterparty. And this requirement might also be met if the upward adjustment is subject to a 0% taxation. If the legislative proposal is implemented in its current form, the new rules will enter into force on January 1st, 2022. However, please note that the legislative proposal also applies to assets acquired from a related party against the non-arm's length price in the 5 years preceding 2022. I hope that this video clarifies more about this new tax proposal. If you have any questions or when you would like to discuss if this legislative proposal could have an impact on your company, please feel free to contact me.